Hello, everybody. Welcome back to my channel. Today, we are in natural light again. We're in my very echoey office, so I apologize again for the sound. It's one of the last videos I'm going to be having in here. Thank goodness we move in like less than a week, so I'm so, so excited. But we are doing something completely different for my channel. I'm actually going to be doing a reaction video today. Reacting to what, you ask? Mariah Carey, the queen. Mimi, she's everything, okay? The ultimate diva, the elusive chanteuse, Mariah Carey, okay? I'm gonna be reacting to my top 5 Mariah Carey vocal moments, okay? These are the ones that I'm personally so obsessed with. If people ask me like, ooh, show me a Mariah video, which no one does, but when I forcibly make them watch Mariah Carey videos, I show them typically one of these 5 videos. So if you want to see my reaction and my top 5 favorite Mariah Carey vocal moments, then sit back, relax, enjoy this video, and don't forget, like this video, subscribe below, give me a thumbs up, and hit that notification bell. Okay, now that I'm scooted to the side, so I have room for the video over here, I'm gonna set the scene first. Okay, it's 1996, Mariah's on tour, we're in Tokyo, we're at the Tokyo Dome, and this is a performance of Hero. Okay, so Hero, everyone kinda likes that, was a big ol' hit. However, I don't think everyone knows about this specific performance where she adds a couple extra sassy riffs, and yeah, there's some goodness that we don't normally hear. So we'll dive right in. Okay, so just to like start out, this is already like Mariah, just like already sounding her best. The voice sounds super clear here. Everything sounds really open and comfortable for her. So I just, she's setting you up to let you know that shit's about to get real.
And then a hero comes along with the strength to carry on. Cause you know you can.
Okay, so there she's giving us like a taste. It's like you get the little voice crack on the run, which obsessed with, and then she's giving you a little, ooh, a little option, a little, ooh, survive. Yes, okay. Okay, so before we get to like the climax, the moment I'm talking about, I do wanna note this is also my favorite Mariah hand period. If you're wondering what I mean, this was full, like, almost Celine Dion choreography sometimes, except Mariah was like either, she went through a period where she would swap the music out or she would just swing. But this was a time of Spirit Fingers, and oh, it gives me so much life, Spirit Finger yelling Mariah. But okay, let's dive in. This is like the moment, okay. Okay, goosebumps, do we understand? I've seen it 1,000 times and every time it gives me goosebumps. Okay, that riff and that option, oh my gosh, yes.
And there will be tomorrow, and in time you'll find the way.
I mean, come on. We're gonna give that like one little, that little high riff, just like one more little listen.
And in time you'll find the way.
Oh, you guys, it's just so, so, so good. Just at this point in her career, absolutely untouchable vocally. Untouchable. Okay, next we're moving on to Baby Mariah. So number 2 here, this is 1991. We're at Arsenio Hall. She's singing Emotions, okay? Need I say more? The song is iconic. This specific performance is like one of her first television appearances. She's so fresh, she looks so excited and serves like insane vocals. So let's dive in. Yes. This set is everything. The outfits, this giant hair with those horrible bangs. Okay, Mariah is, she's sounding young, she's sounding fresh, she looks excited, we have a sparkle in the eyes. This song is so hard and she's already serving it, so I mean, give it to me, girl.
I feel good, I feel nice, I've never felt so satisfied, I'm in love.
Okay, so like this is like a testament to like the range really early on. People were very obsessed with Mariah because they were like, oh my gosh, this range. She had the whistles right off the bat. She had this crazy low range. I think it's 5-6 octaves, something crazy she has access to vocally. And it is like, it's so insane and no one had heard it. So to hear her start out so low and then pop up like an entire like octave 2 seconds later, it's just in a full belt. It's just, it's so exciting to hear. And it was like thrilling for people at the time. So I'm just already just feeling the electricity. Come on, come on. Okay, who else besides Ariana Grande? She's the new exception to the rule. However, before her, who else? Come on, that is sickening. That is everything. Ugh. Get out of here. Okay, so like, we get a generally fun performance. I'm gonna skip to the end because that's where the real magic happens. She said, you know what? I need a minute. I need to, I need to swallow a little bit, get that soft palate lowered. She needed a second because it's worth the wait. Tell me who's better. I'll wait. I mean, that is, it's insanity. She sounds like a fucking bird. It is, it's like a who? Who, what even is that noise? Let's go back. It's just insanity, so good. Okay, so our next performance, it's 2005. I believe it's at like the BET Blueprint show. It's like a reveal party for her album, Emancipation of Mimi. So she's doing a little set. Here she's doing her first single, Vision of Love. But this is a vocal moment for Mariah I love because she's definitely matured at this time. It's been like 15 years since she started in the biz, and so she's paid her dues, she's had some fun, she's had a divorce, she has been through it, okay? So the voice is changed. However, this I think is like my second favorite Mariah vocal time because it's a little busty, like a little, she's a little raspy. However, the range is still there, so she's just slaying and working her ass off on this stage, okay? So this is one of my favorites. Let's just dive right in. Time out. Time to fuck out. I totally forgot it started like that. That is, it's like a whisper of whistle in the wind. She was like, let me warm up real quick. Just squeak. Okay, I'm ready. What is that? Oh my God. I forgot about that. This just got even better. This may move up in the ranks by the end of this.
The one that was waiting for me.
Okay, I also really love this performance because Mariah looks like she's having like the best time. Like she's so excited to be there. You can tell she invited like most of these people probably because this shit, everyone, she's glowing. She's like, hello, how are you?
I pray through the night. eyes felt so alone.
So you see what I mean? Like, that is, the top of that range is so raspy, but she is getting it out. She is serving us a vocal. We're getting cracks in the voice on the riffs, but they sound so good still. They're still pretty controlled. I am just, whew, obsessed with this Mariah.
To be strong, so
yes. Oh, get it out of there. Growl it, swing it out, Mariah. Yes. Give me that growl. I love this. Okay, let's restart that one more time. I love that riff, love that option, love the yelling. Yes.
Just throwing the one that I need, I would find me eventually, yeah.
Okay, so from here on out, she is no longer Mariah Carey. For the remainder of the performance, Mariah is taken over by a demon angel. I don't know, she's possessed, but it works.
It was all that you'd given to me. I had a vision of life.
This woman is the only performer in the world who I know who can literally drag out a phrase for 5 fucking minutes and everyone's like, more, yes, give it to me. And by everyone, I mean me.
Take your time, little.
That you turn out to.
Another moment where I get full-on goosebumps, like literally insane, because that just belt, yell, growl, riff, whistle. What? How? How does she do it? A dark witch. And I love her. Okay, so number 4 takes us to the 1998 VH1 Divas Live concert. Okay. Everything about this performance is peak Mariah for me, okay? The look, the attitude, the raspy-ass voice, still giving me vocals. She's running around the stage. This is my Mariah. Like, Butterfly era 97 to 99 Mariah, she is my girl. Like, this is my everything. Okay, she's doing Make It Happen, and y'all, she's gonna make it happen.
I'm doing my best to be a diva this evening.
Okay, doing her best. Let's just start there. Doing her best to be a diva. This performance comes from the second half. Mariah's having a great time, but we're gonna skip there. She is struggling to get that note out. Oh my gosh, I live for the swinging arm. I live for that. Oh, I live for that. Yes. Yes. Okay, right there. I mean, clear, belting, serving you everything, giving you yes, 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 bitch. And then. Right here is when Mariah's taken over by another demon. So, get ready. Run it.
You're gonna make it, you're gonna
I love that option so much. Just so much.
Make it happen.
I mean, it's got everything you want. We have attitude, we've got vocals, we've got looks. Need I say more? Okay, rounding out the list here at number 5, it's 1992, we're at the Grammy Awards, I think. Yes, we're at the Grammys, and she's singing If It's Over. So this is kind of like a deep track from the Emotions album, one of my absolute favorites, literally so good. Give it a listen, y'all. Well, you're going to now, but give it a real listen. It is impeccable. Mariah looks great here. She is effortless and just so, so good, so underrated.
Won't you talk to me? Look at me.
I know, like, a lot of times I complain or people complain that Mariah doesn't do anything but sing, but here is one of the few moments I think I really connect with this performance, because I really feel like she is performing this to someone in her mind. Like, she's doing this for the audience, sure, but I feel like she's really zoned in on something and it feels really personal. Like, the whole song does. I feel like she's really giving something into this. It's a little heartbreaking, but so beautiful. And I think that's why I love it so much. Yeah, so good.
Oh, it is unfair. It is unright. If it's really gonna, then tell me tonight.
Okay, noting right away, I do love this performance. She really does sound tired here though. You can tell, like, there's some definite vocal fatigue going on. But she still churns it out, and this is definitely, like, when you're this young, I think she was, like, 21 here, maybe 21, you can pretty much do whatever you want and still get away with singing the next day perfectly. But yeah, no, she definitely sounds a little tired here. Yeah, do you see what I'm talking about? Those closed notes at the top, over, like, just really tight. And so that's a really good indication that she's pretty vocally fatigued. And it's like compensating with vocal like with your musculature in your neck, kind of squeezing and tensing up to get the note to come out. So yeah, you can tell she's a little tired, but still sounding stunning. Yes. That riff is fast as hell and so clean. Oh, yes. Oh my gosh. I'm gonna go back because you can't hear it that well. But these belts, they're clear. They're high as hell. So beautiful. And she gives a whistle and they don't turn the mic up enough because she, like, pulls back a little bit. But oh my gosh, I'm gonna go back and hopefully you can hear it this time.
For your honesty, won't you give it to me?
Yes.
Baby, if it's so, why don't you let me know if it's a, oh, let me.
I mean, oh, the goosebumps, you guys. Ooh, that one is, I love that so much.
Go.
Always a thank you afterwards. She looks sparkling and beautifully glowing. The performance is so good. I love that song so much. Yeah, that was number 5, guys. It's the end of the video. Okay, everybody, that brings us to the end of today's video. If you guys liked this and you want to see more stuff like this, or some different content. I keep trying new stuff because I'm just having a lot of fun with the channel right now. But if you like this, give me a thumbs up. That is so big. It really helps me out a ton. Comment below. I just love to hear from you guys. Subscribe to the channel, of course. Hit that notification bell so you can see every time I post something new. And as always, thank y'all so much for watching. I love y'all.